Experts say there is an urgent need to domesticate the African mining vision to ensure that citizens understand their contribution and benefits from the mining sector. These views were raised during a high-level meeting in Kampala on domestication of the African mining vision, attended by policymakers, civil society organizations, academia, among other stakeholders. Speaking during the meeting, Herbert Kafero, the programs and communications manager at Seattini Uganda, disclosed that they are currently undertaking various efforts advocating for an Afrocentric, just and equitable energy transition in the East African Community region and Africa.
A number of policy frameworks were put forward, and the Africa Mining Vision is part of those policy frameworks. So the Africa Mining Vision is concerned with changing Africa, contributing to Africa's structural economic transformation. And it's part of Agenda 2063, the blueprint for Africa's quest for structural transformation. And when we talk about climate change, how it's intensifying, we also recognize that there is a scramble for critical minerals, and Africa has huge deposits of these critical minerals. So Africa is indeed at the center.
He also said there is need to interrogate the efficacy of existing policy frameworks around, especially in view of Africa's quest for structural formation. The African continent is currently the center of attraction due to its huge deposits of the world's reserves of minerals, essentials for renewable energy technologies like solar panels and electric vehicles, 5% of cobalt, 47.65% of manganese, and 5.9% of copper, among others. As the climate crisis intensifies, the global demand for these critical energy transition minerals could even increase almost fourfold by 2030.
With the mineral resources, but unfortunately, despite that, we still wallow in poverty. And it's a shame even that the people that pick the resources from us are the ones that give us aid, are the ones that lend us the money, give us grants, yet we have the resources that we could actually use to better our lives as not just Ugandans, but Africans as a whole. And the Minerals and Mining Act, I strongly believe, is quite detailed enough. And looking at the Africa vision and the mining vision, I think most of the issues therein were actually taken care of in this Mining Act.
We do not have regulations, and we are thinking of the domestication in 2024. I think we are far, but I request that maybe some of these reports shared with our representatives in the Pan-African Parliament, because I know they are very active these days. So when you look at the provisions of the AM, African Mining Vision, even for them, they think that, for example, we have actualized all taxes. And yet Uganda, from what he has just said, we have not even actualized the taxes. And then they also presuppose that we have spent the incomes from mining when we are not there, because we have even failed to incorporate the transparency provisions. So the vision thought that at least those are covered, but for Uganda we have not yet covered even the.
This is raising concern to policymakers. Africa now has a historic opportunity to unleash a wave of structural transformation in some of the countries that need it most, but harnessing this potential requires more than mere geological fortune. Africa is estimated to be losing around $100 billion annually due to limited value addition on its minerals. This is because many African countries export raw materials without processing or refining them, thereby missing out on the opportunity to add value and create jobs. According to the African Development Bank, Africa's mineral exports could be generating an additional $100 billion in annual revenue if they were processed and refined on the continent.